Hey guys, how are you? It's Mike with The Helpful Dad and 40 Plus Fitness. Here today, we're going to talk about what's the best shoe should you use if you're going to do Tough Mudder or one of these other obstacle course races. We'll talk about hiking shoes, running shoes, different types of shoes, and we'll try to determine, what would be the pros and cons of these shoes. And I'll give you the shoe that I actually run in as well too. So, before we get started, if you're going to do Tough Mudder, you want to get the Tough Mudder headband. Or you're going to do Savage Race, you want the Savage Race medal, or you're going to do Warrior Dash or Spartan Race or Rugged Maniac or any of these other obstacle course races out there that's getting very popular. Things that I love to do, that obviously you love to do if you're watching this video. If you're going to do these things more than once, you're probably going to want to get a shoe that is going to last, something that you can use multiple times. A lot of times when you do these races the first time, they actually promote, just throw away your shoes in a big pile at the end. Well, that's all well and fine if you're only going to do the race one time or you have an old pair of shoes you want to get rid of. But if you're going to do the races consistently, you don't want to keep throwing away a $100 pair of shoes, right? So this is the shoe that I run in, and I've got a full review on this in another video as well too. And there's other ones out there that you can research. And this really need to be the shoe that you need to get, or certainly the color if you don't like this color. But this is the New Balance Minimus. And I'll talk to you why I like this shoe and some of the benefits of this versus some other shoes that I've run in as well too. But first of all, if you're going to do one of these obstacle course races, you're going to want to get a shoe that is lightweight, that's durable, and that's going to offer you protection against the obstacle courses that you're going through. I have found that this shoe actually meets those criteria. First of all, it has the Vibram sole technology with those waffle cone kind of designs on the bottom. Now you could say, well, Mike, those are going to get clogged up when you go through mud. And yes, that is true. But the thing about this is it drains very well, so it's very easy to unclog that. If look at running shoes or that's going to tend to hold that mud a little bit more. And obviously, any shoe that hold mud is going to get heavier and heavier as the course goes along. And we're talking about doing a 12-mile course like Tough Mudder, or six for Savage Race, something like that. After a few miles, you don't want bricks on your feet. You want a lightweight shoe. And so you want a sole that's going to be very easy to, get rid of the debris and stuff that clogs on it. But you also want a shoe that's really a sole that's durable to give you protection when you go over rocks and you're climbing over different types of terrain, sand and mud and dip uphills, downhills, if you're going through water or what have you. You want a sole that will be able to take it all and still give you protection. Now, this particular shoe doesn't have a steel plate in it like some hiking shoes would, or even some off-road running shoes. But I found that steel plate not necessarily necessary when you're doing these types of obstacle course races. At least so far, it hasn't proved necessary for me, because there really isn't anything like, super sharp rocks or something you'd get on a technical trail, that you're hiking on or something like that. And plus, that steel plate would add a lot of weight, and we don't necessarily want that. So the other thing I like about this particular shoe is it kind of gives you that what's all the rage right now, which I'm a big believer in, is that zero plane running surface. This actually has a 4-degree angle. There are some shoes you can get that have a 0-degree angle, but you notice it's much smaller heel than you get with a normal running shoe. And those big heels on those running shoes are great for cushioning. And if you're a heel striker, that's good, or sometimes it will cause you to strike your heel and run off on your foot. For me, that's not the best way to run. I have found that I get a lot more back pain and knee pain when I'm running than normal running shoes. These new shoes that have this smaller heel tends to cause you to strike on your midfoot, which has really helped me to be able to run farther and longer with less discomfort in my knees and my back. And I'm over 40, so that's important for me. And so I have found these shoes to be very helpful there. The other thing that I like about it is that it's a very lightweight shoe. If you look, the top is really thin material. It's a mesh material. I'm not sure if how much you can see that, but it drains extremely well. So a running shoe or a hiking shoe, these things are going to clog up and fill up with mud. And after the course of a few miles, they're going to get heavier and heavier. This shoe drains so well. I have even swam in this shoe during the Savage Race, the last one I did. I swam in this shoe without any issues. Never had to take them off. Saves you some time. I know it's always not always about time when we're doing these races. We just want to finish them and have the sense of accomplishment. But if you don't have to untie your shoes when you're swimming, that's a positive thing. Also found this shoe to be very durable for me. It's done a couple races for me. Like I said, it has that Vibram technology. There are other shoes though with Vibram technology, particularly ones that I see a lot of people running in, is the five-toe Vibram shoes. And those are very popular now, but I'd have a question for you as the listener right here. I have never run in those five-toe shoes, and I know they give you that flat angle technology, which is good for kind of barefoot running. But I tell you, if there's one shoe that I see coming off in these obstacle course races more than any other in the mud, it's that five-toe shoe, because you know it just doesn't seem to have the ability to wrap around your foot in the back, and it seems like when people are running through mud, those things come off very easily. Now the good thing is they go back on very easily, and maybe they're extremely comfortable and they're very good for running in the same way that I like this particular shoe, but I do see those shoes come off a lot in the mud. I've got another friend of mine that he wears a sailboating shoe. It's called a Docksider. It's got a lot of, it drains the water extremely easy. Still has a runner sole on the bottom. You can look that up and find out more information about that. He swears by that. He's done a couple races in them and he loves them because they drain so well. Like I said, I tend to go with more of an actual running shoe that's built for off-road racing. Another one that would be good would be the Merrell Trail Glove, would be another one that I think that would also be very similar to this as well, too. But hiking shoes, I see people doing these races for the first time in hiking shoes, thinking that would be good because it is an off-course race. But the problem with that is it can be very heavy. I mean, after you've done a few miles and that mud and gunk is kicked up on those shoes, you really are running in bricks. And I don't know, you know, and again, is it the best shoe to actually run a long distance in? Maybe, maybe not. It doesn't seem like it would work for me very well. But, you know, that's just my opinion. Again, I'd love to know what your thoughts are. Do you run in something like the shoe that I'm recommending? Do you use something else? You know, again, if you're only doing this race like the Tough Mudder one time and one time only, and you've got an old pair of shoes and that's your favorite pair of running shoes and you're just ready to get rid of them, hey, wear those, you know, and then throw them away at the end, and you know, they donate those shoes and it goes to a good cause. But if you're going to do these races over and over again, you probably want to invest in a good pair of shoes. So that's my recommendation for you today. I hope that's helpful for you. Like I said, please share your thoughts with me. Let me know what you think, and we'll see you at one of these races next time. God bless you.